Hey, what's up? Today I want to work on another sunrise image, and for this video I want to turn this photo into a very colorful and warm sunrise image, and I probably will add a lot of glow as well as some heavy vignetting. So before I start, let's first check out the before and after images. And as you can see, I'm using Adobe Photoshop for the post-processing. That means I'm going to use the Camera Raw Editor for the basic raw adjustments. But don't worry, this is basically the same as Lightroom, just with a different user interface. So let's start in the Lens Correction tab on the right side, right here. And let's activate those two settings just to get rid of the chromatic aberration and reduce the lens distortion a little bit. And let's switch back to the basic tab. Since I want this to be a colorful image, I want to boost the saturation, and I can start this by changing the camera profile to Adobe Landscape. As you can see, this will boost the shadows, but also give the image some more base saturation. Now I don't want to change the white balance too much since I like the colors already. I may want to add some more tint, which will give the image a more purple look, and I think that fits the sunrise pretty well. Alright, and right now the image is super dark in the foreground, while there also aren't many details in the sky, so let's first increase the exposure so we get some nice detail everywhere. Of course, this will make the brighter parts way too bright, but I can easily fix that by simply dropping the highlights. And now we have detail in the brighter areas, while we also can see stuff in the darker parts. But let's further work on the darker parts by increasing the shadows a little bit. Okay, then I want to add some structure and sharpness to this image. I can do that by simply increasing the clarity and some texture. And I think that's already it for the basic global adjustments. Then let's work on the local adjustments for a little bit. You can see I have created two gradiated filters already. Let's start working on the upper one for the sky. And as said in the intro, I want to add some vignetting to this image. So to do that, I can simply drop the exposure. And that works pretty well with the glow on the horizon. Then let's go check out the foreground gradiated filter. Here I want to add some more structure to this thing in the foreground. So let's further increase the clarity here. And since I think this area is still a bit dark, let's also increase the whites, which will make this area a bit brighter. All right. Then I want to enhance the center part of the image, mainly the glow above the horizon. So you can see I have created three different sized radial filters. Let's start with the smallest one. I'm going to use this one to add a little bit of glow by increasing the blacks. And I further want to warmen up the sky in the center part of the image, so I'm starting this by increasing the temperature. Okay, then next let's go to the bigger one right here. Again, I want to warmen up this area by increasing the temperature. And I can really add a lot of color here. And let's also add some tint. Okay, that looks nice. I'm still not satisfied with the brightness in this area, so let's increase the whites once more. Now when looking at the histogram, you may notice the very far right side is a little bit overexposed, but in this case I really don't care if these areas are overexposed, since I will probably add some glow over it later in Photoshop. But let's go on with the biggest radial filter. Again, I want to start by increasing the temperature. And let's also add some tint again. And finally, make the area brighter by increasing the whites. Okay, and that's it for the local adjustments. Then let's do some more color grading in the HSL tab. I want to start by increasing the orange color saturation, and I also want to boost the blues a little bit. Okay, then let's also go to the luminance tab, and here I simply want to boost the orange luminance just to make the area above the horizon a little bit brighter. Let's do some final color grading with the split toning. Since this is a sunrise shot, I'm going with the warm color tone for the highlights, of course, and increase the saturation. Okay, then the final part for the raw adjustments, the sharpening. And now I can open the image in Photoshop. And of course, the first thing I want to fix, I want to get rid of those tree branches. And here I'm simply using the spot healing brush, which should get rid of them easily. And I can also fix the vignetting caused by the wide angle lens I used here. Then let's go on with the right side of the image. I might also want to remove some of those spots in the water. Okay, looks much better now. Then let's see, maybe I want to add a few Nicollection filters. I guess to add a dreamy look to this picture, the classical soft focus will work quite nicely by applying the soft look over the whole image. But since right now it's a bit too bright, so I'm choosing a different method. I think the second soft focus method does look quite nice. Okay. Since I only want to have the soft look over the center of the image, I'm applying a layer mask on this classical soft focus layer. And then I'm inverting the layer mask by hitting Ctrl I. This will fill the layer mask with black and thus make it invisible. Now to make parts of the glow visible again, I'm simply setting the foreground color to white and pick the brush tool. And then I'm painting over the area where I want to have this glow effect applied. Okay, looks good to me. Then let's merge those two layers by selecting them and hitting Ctrl E. And then I also want to remove this chain here, since I think it's kind of annoying, so I'm again using the spot healing brush. Okay, then let's further work on the glow. So I'm applying a new layer and change its blending mode to hard light. And I'm picking the brush tool. And now I'm holding down the Alt key and click on the area where I want to apply the glow. And this way I can simply pick the color. And now to apply the glow, I'm also reducing the brush opacity to 10% to not make the glow too strong. And then I'm starting to paint in a little bit of glow here. And then after adding the glow, I also want to do some dodging and burning. So let's create another new layer and switch the blending mode to overlay this time. And then I'm using the brush tool again. First, I'm picking a black color to make a few areas a bit darker, like the top of the image. And as you can see, when I'm brushing in, the area will get darker. And of course, I can do the same thing with white and this way make the area a bit brighter. And at this point, I want to stop the editing. I hope this was an interesting and helpful video. If you have any questions regarding the editing, then please let me know in the comments. And thank you very much for watching this video.